I don't know why my connection is dying today. Are we back? Are we back? Yep, we are back. Sorry about that. I don't know why the connection is not stable. It's not my CPU. I have enough. Yeah, it's like 20% of my system is being used and half of it is not, so should be okay. Okay, I was saying React Bootstrap. I didn't like React Strap, so let's start with this one. So React Bootstrap, how do you work? Let me turn on the lights. React Bootstrap, I need a CSS. I don't want to get it from the CloudFront. Okay. So this was in storybook in the configuration. Okay, so this would be require React Bootstrap. Do you actually ship the connection React Bootstrap? The CSS, I mean. React Bootstrap. So this, seriously? Okay, so I actually need this from the CSS. I mean, this is from the Bootstrap. So that is not the version I want, probably. Bootstrap. Yeah, this was from 4, so I need to drop that. So just remove Bootstrap for now and add. Bootstrap version 3.0. Version 3 in general. Which version am I getting? 337. That's cool. So in here in the main, not there, in the storybook. Okay, I implement that CSS. Maybe I don't need this anymore. Maybe the, yeah, that was for centering and stuff. Okay, so Bootstrap is there. What else now? No, Bootstrap this CSS, Bootstrap CSS is not there. Node modules, bootstrap this CSS, bootstrap CSS. Is there, bro? What's that? No, really? Oh, no. Why? Is there? Do I need to restart Storybook? Okay, the CSS is there. It looks like shit. But it's there. Good. Moving forward. Now, not more React strap. Let me remove that. And remove React strap. I'm sorry. What we are going to do instead is use socket bootstrap, show me the 337. And yes, this is documentation components navbar. Okay, so the elements are called so I would need a navbar dot header. Can you actually do this? No, you can't, right? Is this re-imported? So can I go there and see if it... Ah, yeah, they are. Import it in the lift like this. Okay, so just from navbar. Okay, and then you have navbar, none of this. Collapse out. Yeah, let's go with left navigation for now, which is navbar.header. No, not a header. Oh, just nav. Easy. Nav. And then you export nav item, same name, that's cool. And inside there you just have a nav item. It has an href, and you just render the word in there. Yeah, this API is even better. There, this is friends. Cool, and this is messages. Nav item, and that's left navigation, which is from nav. Cool. Now, do you have navbar brand? I don't know how this is going to work. Do I need the header? Maybe. Okay. Let's try with this for now. This is just a link. Okay, and then the right navigation. Let's have this drop down for now. So we don't have the collapse or the theme navbar. We just have navbar. Okay, so I need to import this and import menu item. Cool, let's see how does this, how this looks. Who is importing React Strap? Look for this in clients web. But I'm not. Dang. So let me comment out or kind of do this so until I port them. Who else? Login buttons. Yeah, don't do that. Who else? Private package. Oh. This didn't help. Private package. Just comment out everything. File card public page. I just want to see the navbar and login buttons. Comment out the story. Nav link is not defined. Okay. Story. No. Index. I don't need that. Stateless function cannot have refs. Okay. Who has a ref? A ref to what? Are you bored? Yes, I know. What is that? I don't know what is this. The above recording component. Nav, okay. What? Oh, ref not this. Href. Stupid mistake. Okay. Okay, we have the navbar and it doesn't look that bad. Actually, this is probably better if I use this layout. Let me switch this layout there. Yep. Okay, so this is my navbar. Okay. Yeah, out. This is my navbar. Now what's going on? Styling this. What are the problems here? Okay, you're good, you're good. This navbar, it doesn't have any flex attribute. So you are flex. Ah, this is going to be a problem. Because I can't access this container, I think. Okay. React strap. React bootstrap. Maps. Navbar. So the way you work, you have pull right and pull left. Do you have a pull center? You modules, custom styles, no. Layout. Pull left, just say, okay. Not a lot of documentation there. From the navator, right? Component visual, contextual style, no. So I want the nav to center stuff. Because the problem is, I only have access to this nav, right? If I put flex here and this doesn't have the flex, this container inside, I can't change it. Okay. I guess you can, yeah, okay, I know how to do this. So you are going to be my theme nav. Okay, and then what you're going to have is your first div, which is a class container, I think. Yes, so first of all, you are a flex element. Well, so you don't have to be, the container has to. So go, boom, 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 boom. Okay, and your theme nav. Whoops, didn't like it. What happened? What? So root has the nav bar. All right, you're actually theme nav bar. Yeah, not a lot of progress today. Oh, wait, better. Doing things. Container. You are flex now. Awesome. Wait, what is that M5 flexbox? What is that? Do we actually have flex? I'm trying to figure out if Bootstrap 3 provides some flex tooling. Which does not. Okay, anyway, I can do this here. What did happen? Too much undo. Actually, I don't need this. Okay, so now you are a flex element. And I can change this guy to actually kill this margin and navbar. Yeah, I can have this. So now you are pull right, and you don't work. Why don't you work? Because I'm... Yeah, I don't care about pull, just use my flex properties, please. Okay, so you are type flex, and then you are, where are you, display flex, you are not flex either, yes. So you are left navigation navbar. Right, left navigation bar, you are also display flex. You are display flex as well. CSS flex, I like it. Okay, much better. And are you center? Yes, you seem to be. So this is 430, and this is 430 as well. And you are in the center. That's cool. And do you like this? Yeah, kind of. So this size, more or less. Okay, yes, I just need to change the sizes a little bit. Cool. Now back to the colors. Same navbar, you also have this. This color and this color. Much better. Much, much better. Okay, the links, every nav item. What are the nav items? So the nav item are Helvetica, white, font size. Where is the size here? Size. That doesn't tell me a lot. Size 16. Okay. So you are nav item, you come from style and nav item, and you have font face from family Helvetica. Text decoration, I think the uppercase thingy. No, test. Text rendering. I forgot even the basic CSS properties, man. Text transform, uppercase. Text transform, uppercase. And you are theme nav item. Here. How do you look? Oh, ooh, nice. We said you're white. Why are you not white? I need to put that in here, right? Nope. Yes? No? What's the deal with the color? Okay. Oh, because it has a special style for this. Okay, so you are that, and then the link that you have inside is color FFF, also known as white. but you still don't work. Why? Why is this? No? It's not meant to be used like that? Yes. I think this is the syntax. Let me check that. This is also valid. Okay, what's the problem? White. Okay, so this class, where is this class defined? Start components blah. It did work for this. Why is not working for this? Oh, why it is? Because this is more specific. Okay. I shouldn't do this, but you know. Awesome. Okay. So while, yeah, I can still do the other bits. So this would be the logo. This is the logo. How can I? What happened there? Oh, geez, I don't know how to use this. Okay. So we have this image. How do we export this as an image? Oh, can I use SVG for this? That would be cool. Oh yes, I can. Oh yes. Down again. Ah.